Brother, a Hindu sister, talking to her, I couldn't convince her regarding reverting. Like, she was telling, we Hindus, we don't convert people, and then I had to keep quiet. I told her about the concept of hell and heaven and all those things, but she was not convinced. So how to convince a Hindu regarding reverting or converting people?
Sister has a question that when she spoke to the Hindu, she says, we Hindus don't convert or revert. How can you convince him? So he said, become a Muslim and then revert, so you'll no longer be a Hindu. So where's the question of you doing that? The thing is there that you tell the person that you submit your will to God and use the verse of the Quran, Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 64, Ta'ala wa laqalmitum sawaim baina bainakum. That come to common terms as in asanyu, which is the first term, Allah na'budu illa Allah, that you worship none but Allah. So proof to the Hindu from the scriptures, okay, you're a Hindu, you're a practicing Hindu, do you believe in Hindu scriptures? They say yes. So proof from the Hindu scriptures, God is one, that there's no idol worship, etc. Once you do this, then you say that Almighty God has got no images, idol worship is wrong, from their scripture. Keep the Quran aside, from their scripture. Once you prove that, then tell you have to submit your will to the Almighty God. They say, I submit. So a person who submits will to Almighty God in Arabic is called as a Muslim. Muslim in Arabic means a person who submits the will to Almighty God. So you tell that, do you believe God? Yes. Do you submit the will? Yes. Then you're a Muslim. No, I'm not a Muslim. So that means don't submit the will to God. If you tell a person that, do you submit the will to God? Yes. Then you're a Muslim. A Muslim is a person submit to God. Now, whether he's a true Muslim or fake Muslim, that's secondary. Whether he truly submits to a true God or fake God, that you go secondary. So you tell the person, you believe in God? I believe in God. Do you submit the will? Yes. That means you're a Muslim in Arabic. No, I'm not a Muslim. Let me not submit a will to God. So if you ask the person that, are you mandar? Yes. Then you're honest. No, but I'm not honest. See, a person will never say that. Are you mandar? If you ask in Hindi, he says yes. That means honest in English. He says yes. Because they understand English and Hindi. So now you tell them in Arabic, for a person who submits his will to God is a Muslim. Fine? So similarly, that way, a person who lives in India is a Hindu. That way, I'm a Hindu. That is geographically. But if you say Hindu who does idol worship, then I'm not a Hindu. So similarly, if you submit your will to God, you're a Muslim. And then you have to prove to that Hindu what is the true concept of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, true concept of God. And you can refer to my video cassette, Similarities Between Hinduism and Islam, which speaks in great detail. So give this cassette to her, this tape to her, let her think. But how to give the last push is important. The push, last push. Otherwise, you do your job, but you don't have the last push. So how to give the last push is important, and choosing a word is important. Normally, therefore, when I quote Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 19, Inna deena indallahi al-Islam. The only religion acceptable in the sight of God is submitting a will to God. So no one has a problem. If I say the only religion correct in the sight of God is Islam, then people have a problem. So the word Islam is the problem. But if I say the only religion acceptable in the sight of God is submitting a will to God, very good, no problem. But if I say in the sight of God, the only thing acceptable is Islam, then there's a problem. Islam, Muslim is a problem. So you translate it, let them come in between, and then let them come toward Islam. And inshallah, it will be, as Allah says in Surah Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 208, Utkhulu fi salmi kaffa. Enter into some wholeheartedly. First, do dawah part by part, and then inshallah, you'll find that people are entering, alhamdulillah. So how to do dawah with hikmah is important. This is hikmah. Sometimes you have to give a slight push, sometimes a big push. Sometimes you have to give them a hand, sometimes you have to give the stick. So depending what is required, that is hikmah, sister. Hope that answers the question. Wa akhir da'wana, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen.